Yes.
Okay, cool.
Good, have a whole event. All right, guys, I'm James, new here, and figured that I'd give a little bit of context to what I'm talking about. So, transferred here, right, from RPI, or from Albany to RPI. And I kind of, I guess, like, during my time in Albany, I was studying business and had a lot of kind of aspirations to create things for the world. And I saw like engineering as kind of that way to make those things a reality, right? So I guess like part of my purpose in life, I feel like, is to leave the world sort of like a better place than I actually inherited. And I think that living for purpose is actually like far greater than like life. So as an intro to social entrepreneurship, what I'm actually quite passionate about. So I guess the idea here is that social entrepreneurs believe that business is a great platform to create change, right? Whereas conventional entrepreneurs kind of see business as a way to make money, social entrepreneur will actually factor in like impact. And I think that like solving problems for people who can't solve them for themselves is like probably one of our biggest responsibilities that's like co-creating the future. So just to share like some of my favorite companies here. So Watsi, right? They're essentially crowdfunding healthcare for people in developing countries. So the story goes that Chase Adam, his name is, he was working in the Peace Corps, he was on a bus, a woman came in, like, asking for money. And usually locals ignore people who are asking for money, but this time they're all paying them. She had papers with her that happened to be their son's medical records. So he was kind of inspired by that, and being from San Francisco, seeing like, the success of Kickstarter, he decided why not do crowdfunding. The Watts became, which is now the first nonprofit that YC did with that. And then you guys know Khan Academy, founder of this. He essentially was like tutoring his cousin and putting math videos on YouTube. And people started to request more videos. He started to get a lot of views. He decided to quit his job as a hedge fund analyst to do this full time. Crazy bit, right? But this is like really awesome because both these companies are doing amazing things for the world and they're still like making profit, right? They're still in that. So that's like pretty awesome. And I think like this kind of inflection point here, I think traditionally, historically, whatever, people who are entrepreneurs, people that I've talked to, they want to wait until they've made themselves before they go and help other people. It's kind of at least my own belief. But I think very soon we're gonna start to see a change in that right now. I believe there's gonna be more B Corps coming out, there's gonna be more millennial social entrepreneurs, and there's kind of like a new economy emerging right now that's going to fuel that. And that economy is founded on a very simple idea. It's called a social impact bond, which is essentially a commitment from government to pay for a product or service as long as your product or service ends up creating social change, measurable social change. So think about that for a second, right? Like, your technology can reduce recidivism or increase illiteracy rates, the government, which is stakeholder financially and social problems, will come to the table and pay you like, money for the success that you're having, right? It's quite powerful. So this is kind of happening right now. And with this social icon, success or innovative solutions to tackle problems are no longer, the risk of that is no longer put on the taxpayer, right? The private investors are actually backing you, the government's only paying if you succeed. That's kind of the nuance to it. So just to give you guys an example, it's not the most intuitive idea, right? There was a prison in the UK, Peterborough prison, that cost $80,000 a year to house an inmate, right? 50% of the short-term offenders will reoffend. So within a year, they'll go right back, right? It's a huge problem financially. And you can see how the right amount of false matter kind of doesn't put this in. But yeah, so if you, as a private company, can work with government, if the government is willing to work with you to do a better job at correcting, right? That's what corrections is all about, like fixing problems, right? Correcting human behavior, then you can obviously see the social impact that you have and also the potential for savings. So the first SIB was in 2010. This guy right here is Toby Eccles. He's getting a TED talk on this topic. He's a social impact investor. He's a director at Social Finance. And he basically is the inventor of this funding model. So he, in 2010, ran the first SIB ever at that prison, at Petersburg Prison. And he had 3,000 participants. And the goal was that he could reduce recidivism by 7.5%, right? So 3.5, whatever the math is. Then you would split the savings with government, right? And it'd be very easy to So isn't that that'd be pretty easy to measure, right? Because you just use historical data and see, hey, there's actually a change here. We now have a lot of money and you just done everything for us. Wizards is reading.
They work.
Definitely it's working.
Alright, plug in and I'll open it from the back. Hey,
shoot.
This Windows S, okay?
Click sources on the HDMI.